I'm Yalin Huang. I'm from Kunsan University, which is the Department of Visual Communication Design. And today I would like to share the experience of this the work we have done for these years. This is the experience about designer and holography media learning. If the development of holography is a map, and I would like to say we are new on the map. I think at the beginning, I should introduce ourselves first. The Hologram 3D Image Lab was established in October 2001. This is the first HoloLab in the visual communication design in Taiwan. And so far, we have 2 faculty and 6 graduate students. And Professor Dieter Jung always gives us a lot of support. He let us know how to use our creativity to this media. Why holography joined to the visual communication design? And most of people know visual communication design used to call graphic design. And graphic design is mean two-dimensional and free design. So we always ask a question, why graphic design have to be afraid? And lots of movies shows the three-dimensional image will become the major image using in the future. So the visual communication design should break through the limitation of graphic design. After some research in the library and the website, we find the answer. The answer is holography. Therefore, I send a proposal to our government and get some budget from the government to set up this lab. That was very big challenge to us because no one of us know what is holography at the beginning. So we spent almost 3 years to set up this lab and also getting to know what is holography. People always ask me why a graphic designer want to join to the field of holography. I always tell them why we start this lab. And I think the advantage of designer to develop holography is we understand the image. From the image thinking, designer can create lots of fun from holography. We start to have some project and idea to work with holography in 2005. And now I'm going to show you the project we have done. This is the first project we've done. The workshop was our first time to open this lab to public. And we call the workshop is hologram and visual design. That was the first time to try a holocross in visual design also. We spent 3 weeks to work on this workshop. Most of students were so nervous about learning this media, which they never knew it before. But after 3 weeks, lots of graduate students had fun with that, and they start to think how they can use holography in their master project. And Professor Dieter Jung helped us to hold this workshop. And these are the work students done. And this group of students, they make a paper cut for the Chinese character and take the recall for that. And this is the second project we done in 2005. And we know we had a hard time to understand holography at beginning, especially from visual communication to holography field. Therefore, we think if we want to show people the fun and the beauty of holography, we should start from some children's book or some illustration. We think it's easier for people to accept this technology. So we make a children's book, we call it Tippy's Adventure. This book, the background of this book is Shikan Lou, which is a very traditional building in Tainan, because Tainan is a historical city in Tainan, historical city in Taiwan. And we have two characters. One is the boy named Tippy, and his horse, you can see there. And we make a model for the horse and take refreshing holography. And we use a dot printer holography to make the ancient Chikanlo map. And where is the mouse? Okay, I got it. Combine holography and animation together. It shows TP on the top of Chikanlo and seeing the people on the street. And we had a small exhibition after we finished the project. We started to build up the dot printer hologram system in the end of 2004. So we had spent some time to try this system. And during this year, we done some Christmas card. I'm going to skip this one. And the project we done in 2006, so far we have two projects. The project one is the application of holography on elementary school geometric curriculum. The second project is we just finished a small exhibition. The concept about this project is there's one kind of block called Soma block. It's very popular to use on the spatial intelligent learning for young kids. And we find many kids have hard time to understand the 2D dimensional instruction, especially when the block hiding behind the others. So we developed this book and help the young kid to understand the Soma block. The following video will show you the concept about this project. Sorry, it's in Chinese.
我们今天上课是数积木。那你们知道我手上这张图有几块积木吗？It
shows the ideas, kids very hard to understand the Soma block. In the two-dimensional image.
13, 13,
and the teacher showed the kids the holography Soma block. And the kids can very easy to understand it. And we also start from a story and combine with Soma block with some character which like turtle, dog, chair, castle, and some basic parts of Soma block. We had exhibition after finished this project. And lots of kids from preschool come to our exhibition and try to read and play Soma block. From our observe, we find kids can read holography image very well and finish the puzzle in short time. And we had a small exhibition this June. These graduate students start to work on this exhibition after one semester training on holography. Actually, they had very limited time to finish their work because they only had 2 weeks. So during the opening of this exhibition, everyone thought they were great to finish this special mission. We call it happy holography. And this is a very interesting work. We combine the clock design and holography together. And we would like to focus on application of holography in the future, especially become the bridge of holography and visual communication design. And I think this is very great chance for me to be here because I can know lots of people who are so professional in holography. Combine all of you, I think I'm still in freshman level. So I do need your great advice and support to help the future development. Thank you.